Hello students, today we are going to start with the chapter number 3, Linear Equation in One Variable. This video is brought to you by Sri Vasishtha Vidyalaya and made by Appu Singh Thakur. Now let us see what are the things we are going to study in this chapter. First, introduction. Second, equation versus expression. Then linear equation in one variable. Solving linear equation with number on one side. Solving linear equation with variable on both side, solving equation reducible to linear equation, then application of linear equation. Now the first point was introduction. So let us see. Now the first question that arises in our mind, that is, what is linear equation? So for that, let us take an example. Now here you can see this is a big boy and here this one is small boy. Now if we assume that this big boy having 8 chocolate with him. Now he gave certain number of chocolate to his small brother. Now we don't know how much chocolate he might be given to his small brother. But after giving those chocolate, he having only 6 chocolate with him. So for that, if we want to make an equation, so it will be x plus x is the number of chocolate with the small boy plus 6, the number of chocolate which is left with the big boy, that is equal to 8. Now if we send this plus 6 that side, so it will become minus 6. So 8 minus 6, the answer will be 2. So now here we can clearly see that this small boy is having 2 chocolate with him. So this type of equation are known as linear equation in one variable. Now the word one variable, we are using here the word linear equation in one variable. Now try to understand that this 1 stands for this x, because here we are only using a single variable, that is x. And linear equation, now how we identify that whether this equation is linear or quadratic? So for that you can see here that here this x having a degree of 1, it means like if I want to write z, so if I am not writing any degree here, so automatically it is having 1 degree, remember that. It means whenever we are writing any alphabet and if we are not mentioning there any kind of degree, so automatically that alphabet, we assume that it has only having 1 degree. So if any number that having 1 degree is one type of linear equation, means if we can take example x plus 7 is equal to 5, or we can take y minus 2 is equal to 3. Now these are linear equation in one variable, because only here we are using one alphabet with 1 degree. Remember, one alphabet with 1 degree. That's why it is linear equation in one variable. Now let us see the next topic, that is equation and expression. Now what is the difference between equation and expression? For that, let us see. Here the definition for expression is, an expression is a sentence with a minimum of 2 numbers and at least one mathematical operation. This maths operation can be addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now see what kind of thing you can see, means what type of question you can see, that you can say that it is an one type of expression. So if I will write here 2 plus 8, so this shows one type of expression. If I write here 2 minus 8, this is also one type of expression. If I write here 2 multiply 8, this is also one type of expression. If I write here 2 divided by 8, so this is also one type of expression. It means if we are mentioning this mathematical symbols between these two numbers, so it becomes expression. Remember, an expression is a sentence with a minimum of 2 numbers and at least one mathematical operation. At least one mathematical operation, you can see here. At least having 2 numbers and one mathematical operation. It can be with the variable also, x plus 6 or 7 minus y or 8 divided by x. We can see this type of question also. These are also one type of expression, but this expression are with the variable. So remember, what are expression? An expression is a sentence with a minimum of 2 numbers and at least one mathematical operation. This maths operation can be addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You can see here 2 added to 8. Now here you can see we have 2 number with maths operation addition. Similarly here you can see x and 6 with the maths operation addition. Now the second question arises that what are equations? Okay, what are equations? Now see what definition is given here for equation. An equation is a mathematical statement. An equation is a mathematical statement that two things are equal and it consists of two expressions, one on each side of an equal sign. Now for that you can take this example. See, if I am writing here 2 plus 8, so the answer for this will be 2 plus 8 will be 10. So this is an equation, because here you can see this part is known as LHS and this part is known as RHS. And in an equation, there must be always LHS is equal to RHS for satisfying any kind of equation. If you want to prove any kind of equation, so there must be LHS is equal to RHS. Remember that. So again, I am repeating the same. Equation, an equation is a mathematical statement that two things are equal. Two things are equal. Now you can take this one example also. X plus 6 is equal to 10. So this is also one type of equation. We can take here x plus y plus 6 is equal to 10. This is also one type of equation. But this one is linear equation in one variable and this one is linear equation in two variable. Now why we are using here the word two variable? It is because of here we are using two different alphabet with the 1 degree, that is x and y. Now we can see here that we are using two different variable, x and y. That's why it is two variable. And here we are using only x, so that is one variable. Instead of x, you can take any alphabet, but there should be only one alphabet in all the equation. Remember that. Now here we are using x plus 6 equal to 10. We can take y plus 6 equal to 10, or we can take z plus 6 equal to 10. Any alphabet you can take. But remember that if that equation consists of one alphabet, then we will say that linear equation in one variable. If it contains two alphabet, then linear equation in two variable. And if it contains three alphabets, so we will say that linear equation in three variables. Remember that this two variable and x plus y plus z is equal to 10. So this one is linear equation in three variable. Remember that if it is only one alphabet, then one variable. If it's two alphabet, then two variable. And if it's three alphabet, then three variable. Now you might definitely understood that equation and expression difference, that what are equations and what are expression. Now our next topic is constant and variable. Now for moving ahead, let us try to understand that what are constant and what are variable. So for understanding that, let us take an example. Here you can see that whenever we are using alphabets like x plus 6 equal to 10, if I am using this alphabet x plus 6 equal to 10. So here you can clearly see that this 6 stands for constant. Means any number on its own, any number on its own is a constant. Means whenever we are mentioning any kind of equation, in that equation if you see any kind of number without any variable, it means any number without any alphabets like 10x or 9y, these are not constant. These are not constant. Remember, any number without any variable, any number without any variable with the mathematical operations or with the mathematical symbols, then we can say that it is a constant. Now here you can see that what kind of definition is given here. In an algebra, a constant is a number on its own or sometimes a letter such as A, B or C to stand for a fixed number. Now here you can see that in example x plus 5 equal to 9, here it is given. Here you can see this 5 and this 9 are constant. So remember one thing, that if any number without any variable you are seeing in an equation, so we can say that those are constant. Here this 6 and 10 are constant. Similarly, you can take different example, y plus 10 equal to 20. here this 10 and 20 are constant. Now the second part, variable. Now what are variable? Let us try to understand that. Whenever you are seeing any kind of alphabet or symbols with number, so those are variable. Remember, any alphabet or symbols you are seeing in an equation, those are variable. For example, now see, I had given here one example, 10x and 9y. So these are variable. If you are seeing here 10x plus, here the equation 10x plus 9 is equal to 20. Now here you can see this 9 stands for constant. This 20 stands for constant, but this 10x stands as variable, and this whole is a linear equation with one variable because only one alphabet we are using here. Now let us see our next. So as I told you, now let us begin with the next topic, that is linear equation in one variable. Now as I had informed you earlier, that generally we are writing linear equation in one variable. The general form of writing it, general form of writing it is in the form of ax plus b equal to 0. Generally we are writing linear equation in one variable like this way. And here, this type of equation having only one solution, remember it, this type of equation are only having one solution. Now linear equation are also first degree equations because the exponent on the variable is understood to be 1. As I had told you earlier, that whenever we are writing any type of equation like 6x plus 5 is equal to 10. Now here you can see that this x is having degree 1. So those type of equation are known as linear equation. And why I am telling you that it has only one solution? Let us solve this equation. 2x plus 3 is equal to 8. Send this plus 3 to RHS side. So it will be 2x equal to 8 minus 3 as we are transposing it. So 2x is equal to 8 minus 3. The answer will be 5. So x is equal to 5 by 2. Now here you can see that for x we are getting the answer 5 by 2. That's why I am telling that it has only one solution. Such type of equation are only having one solution. Now our next topic is how to solve linear equation. Now let us take certain example based on that. If I am writing an equation like x minus 2 equal to 7, okay, and if I am transposing this minus 2 to RHS side, so it will be x is equal to 7 plus 2, so our answer will be 9. Similarly, we can take different examples like 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 by 7. Now this is our next example. Now here you can see this x. This x stands for a variable. And here this 3 by 7 is a constant. So remember that first of all, in an equation for getting the answer for a variable, first of all we have to send the constant. So we will send this 3 by 7 to RHS side. So it will be x is equal to 17 by 7 minus 3 by 7. So after solving it, 17 minus 3 will be 14 by 7. And then we will subtract. So we will get the answer 2. Now here you can clearly see that I had solved this linear equation, I got the answer 9. I solved this linear equation, I got the answer 2. So you can see here clearly that in a linear equation, a variable always having a degree of 1. It is no need to write that variable having a degree 1, but we can clearly see that this type of equation, the variable having a degree of 1, and those are 2 and 7 here is constant, here 3 by 7 and 17 by 7 are constant. So after solving a linear equation, we are getting the answer 2. This shows that this type of equation are having one solution. Now the next thing is that second part. Now let us take certain more example based on that. This minus 9, if you will send it to RHS side, so it will be 7x is equal to 16 plus 9. So 7x is equal to 16 plus 9 will be 25. So x is equal to 25 by 7. So it will be not be going to be reduced in the smallest term. So the answer will be 25 by 7. So here is also you can see one more example of how to solve the linear equation. Here again the same thing, this x having 1 degree, so it is a linear equation. And why it is linear equation? Because we are only using one variable and we are finding a solution for this equation. So we are getting 25 by 7. It is only a single solution for this whole equation. You can see that if I put this value here, we are getting LHS equal to RHS or not. Let us see. 7x minus 9 is equal to 16. 7x minus 9 equal to 16. Instead of x, let us write 25 by 7 minus 9 equal to 16. 7, 7, cut. So 25 minus 9 will be 16 equal to 16. It means LHS is equal to RHS. So here you can clearly see that this is the solution. And remember one thing, if you put this solution number in the equation, so definitely you are going to get the answer that LHS is equal to RHS. Or you can say that you can verify your answer if you want to know that whether you, whatever the answer you got, is it correct or not correct. So for that you can put this value in place of x and you can see that LHS, if the LHS is equal to RHS, it means you got the correct answer. And if it is not equal, it means it is not correct. Now for continuing further, let us see certain things that we had studied in standard 7th. Let us recall again those. Now here you can see that transposing plus 3 from LHS to RHS. Okay, let us take an example. Transposing plus 3 from LHS to RHS makes it minus 3. So if we write here like 2x plus 3 equal to 7. So if we are going to transpose this plus 3 from this LHS side to this RHS side, so this plus 3 will go that side, so it will become minus 3. So 2x is equal to 7 minus 3. Then again 2x is equal to 4. And x is equal to 4 by 2, that will be equal to 2. Now, if we take certain more example, transposing minus 3 from LHS to RHS. So again, take the same example, 2x minus 3 equal to 7. So this minus 3 will go that side, so it will become plus 3. So 2x is equal to 7 plus 3, then 2x is equal to 10. Then x is equal to 10 by 2, that will be equal to 5. Then the next, transposing multiply 3. So let us take an example, this one also. If I am writing here 3x is equal to 21. 3x is equal to 21. So here this 3 and x having a relation of multiplication. So this 3 will go that side and become divide. So x is equal to 21 divided by 3. So here the answer will be 7. And if we are sending divide 3, means x by 3 is equal to 7. So it is in divide, so it will go that side and become multiply. So x is equal to 7 multiply 3, that will be equal to 21. Remember, these are the terms and these are the way to solve or transposing the number from LHS to RHS. Got it? Now let us solve certain question based on same. Now here, solving linear equation with variable on one side and on both sides. Here you can see 3x and here you can see 2x. So this is smaller number, so we will send this one from LHS to RHS, and this minus 13 will be from RHS to LHS. So it will be like minus 13 will come this side, so it will be plus 13 plus 7 is equal to 3x, and this plus 2 will go that side, so it will be minus 2. So 13 plus 7 will be 20 is equal to 1x. So here we got the answer, 20 is equal to 1x, because as 1 having no value, so we can say that x is equal to 20. Now in this side you can see that 0.3x and 0.7x, again minus 15 is here, so we'll send this minus 15 to this side and this 0.3x in this side, so it will be minus 15 will come this side, so it will become plus 15 plus 5 is equal to 0.7x minus 0.3x. So here it will be 20 is equal to 20 is equal to 0.4x. So now this both having a relation of multiply, so it will move to divide. So 20 upon 0.4 is equal to x. Now here you can see after 0.1 digit is there, so we will send decimal to the numerator side, so it will be 20 multiplied 10 upon 4 equal to x. 4 ones are 4, 5s are 5, 10s are 50 equal to x. Now let us take certain more example based on that. 5t and 3t. So 3t is smaller number, so we will send this one that side. Minus 3 will go this side, so it will be 5t minus 3t is equal to minus 5 plus 3. Now 5t minus 3t will be 2t. Minus plus minus, 5 minus 3, 2. So minus 2. T is equal to minus 2 by 2. This 2 cancel out, so we are getting the answer minus 1. Now here you can see that how we are getting the answer minus 2, it is because of plus minus minus and sign of greater digit. So here greater digit is 5, so that's why we are putting here minus sign in front of 2. And 5t minus 3t, we will get the answer 2t. Then 2 and t both having relation of multiply, so the 2 will transpose that side, so it will become divide. So minus 2 upon 2, then 2 table 2 comes once time, so that's why 2 ones are 2 and the minus sign is there, so that's why we are putting t is equal to minus 1. Now here, if now see here, we have to solve and check also. Let us see if we are getting the correct answer or not. Now this plus 3x will move that side and plus 9 will move this side, so 5x minus 3x is equal to 5 minus 9. Now 5x minus 3x will get the answer 2x, and 5 minus 9, again the same condition arises here. 5 minus 9 will get the answer 4, but sign of big digit. Now here greater digit 9, so that's why we'll put the value minus. Then x is equal to minus 4, the 2 and x both having a relation of multiply, so 2 will move for divide, so 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So here we are getting answer minus 2. Now let us check LHS is equal to RHS or not. So LHS is equal to 5x plus 9. I mean, place of x put the value minus 2 plus 9. 5 2s are minus 10 plus 9. So here we are getting the answer minus 1. RHS is equal to 5 plus 3x. 5 plus 3 multiply minus 2. So 5 minus 6. Again we are getting the minus. So here you can clearly see that LHS is equal to RHS. It means the answer which we got minus 2, that is correct. Okay, now here 8x. Now this 3 will multiply with this x and 3 will multiply with this 1. So here it will be 8x plus 4 is equal to 3 multiply x will be 3x and 3 ones are 3 plus 7. Now we will separate the constant on a single place and variable on a single place. So we will send this 3x to the LHS side and this 4 to the RHS side. So 8x minus 3x is equal to minus 3 plus 7, minus 3 plus 7, and then this plus 4 will move to the RHS, so it will be minus 4. Then 8 minus 3x will be 5x equal to minus 3 plus 7. Answer will be 4 and sign of big digit, means plus minus 4. Now plus minus minus, 4 minus 4, 0. So here it will be 5x is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 0 by 5. So if any number divided by 0, answer will be 0. Now in this type of question, you can see here this 5, 4 upon 5 having a relation with x plus 10 in bracket, multiply relation. So we will send this 5 of denominator to the numerator, so it will be 5 into x will be 5x, 5x equal to 4 bracket x plus 10. Now this 4 will multiply with x and 4 will multiply with 10, so here it will be 5x is equal to 4x plus 40. Then we will send this 4x to the LHS side, so 5x minus 4x is equal to 40. So 1x equal to 40. So here we got the answer x equal to 40. More example based on the same. Here you can see two denominator numbers are there, numerator and denominator number, and two simple constant numbers are there. So let us send this number this side and this one on that side. So it will be 2x by 3 minus 7x upon 15 is equal to 3, and this plus 1 go to the RHS side, so it will be minus 1. Then here we can see both the denominator are not same. So as the both denominator are not same, we have to make it same. The LCM for these two numbers will be 15. So for making this 3, 15 will multiply it by 5. So 2, 5 is a 10x upon 15 minus 7x upon 15 is equal to 2. Now 10x minus 7x will be 3x upon 15 is equal to 2. 3 1s are 3, 5s are. So x by 5 equal to 2. So now again you can see this 5 is in denominator, so it will move to the RHS side. So that will become multiply with the 2. So it will be 2 multiply 5, the answer will be 10. Similarly here you can see that 2y and y are two variables, and 5 by 3 and 26 by 3 are two different constant. So we will send this minus y to the LHS side and plus 5 by 3 to the RHS side. So 2y plus y is equal to 26 by 3 minus 5 by 3. Now 2y plus y will be 3y, and both the denominator are same, so 26 minus 5 will be 21 by 3. As both the denominator were same, so no need to find the LCM for that, we straightly can solve it. So 26 minus 5 will be 21 by 3. Now 3 1s are 3, 3 7s are. So again here we are getting the answer 3y equal to 7. So y is equal to 7 by 3. Now one more example is here. Now you can see here this 5m. So we will send this 5m to LHS side, so it will be 3m. Now here no sign is here, so that's why we will assume it as plus. So plus 5 will go that side, so it will become minus 5. So minus 5m equal to minus 8 by 5. Now 3m minus 5m, sign of big digit. So minus 5 minus 3, 2m equal to minus 8 by 5. Now both the term are having minus, so we'll cut it out. So 2m is equal to 8 by 5. Now here you can see that 2 and m both having relation of multiplication. So this 2 will move to denominator. So m is equal to 8 upon 5 multiply 2. As here the relation was multiply, so it moves to the denominator. Now 2 1s are 2, 4s are. So here we are getting the answer 4 by 5. Now as I had make you understand earlier also, if you want to check, let us check it out, we are getting the correct answer or not. LHS is equal to 3m. So 3 multiply 4 by 5. So 3 4s are 12 by 5. Now RHS is equal to 5m minus 8 by 5. So here m value is 4 by 5 minus 8 by 5. 5 5 cut. So 4 minus 8 by 5. Now again here we have to take the LCM. So LCM will be 5. So multiply 5, multiply 5. So 4 5 is a 20. 20 upon 5 minus 8 by 5. So 20 minus 8 will be 12 by 5. So here you can see that LHS is equal to RHS.